the Clannies, there it's an award night that we set up. I think we've had 13 or 14 Clannies now. It's been going for like a long time. And we basically, when the Cave Clan, originally it was like 3 or 4 people, then it was 6 or 7 and so on, and then it got up to like about 30 people. And we kind of started saying, oh, you know, we need to have some kind of, like, more functions, more social gatherings. And we were sitting at home, and a couple of us sort of watching the Logies. Well, there was an ad for the Logies or something. And we said, what about an awards night? Yeah, the awards, the problem we had, we needed somewhere big enough, and the only place we could really have it was a place called the Chamber in Anzac Tunnel. And that's in, so we're normally a bit secretive about the location. That's the only thing why it's sort of, but it's in Melbourne. It's just off the Yarra, and it's in a tunnel called Anzac Tunnel, and it's a really, really cool spot. Like, you know, it's a chamber. The Chamber in Anzac became like the main place for the Cave Clan, and usually it's furniture, it's got like a heap of chairs and that down there, although the water board just took them away recently. And it's all carpeted and it's quite comfortable. And a lot of people would go down there and paint, and then other people would go down and eventually it'd get covered over. And so we just thought, we've got this big 100 metre long wall, why don't we make this place more interesting by setting up a gallery? And we basically just painted these white canvases on the wall. And just advertise, like, first we had a few gatherings, like I said, come along and do a painting. And gradually over the last 5 years it's been filling up, and the transit police went down there and destroyed them all, so we had to start again. And I think now, I mean, you probably know better than me, but I think there's probably about 30 or so paintings down there, including a just about a life-size yellow submarine.
In the town where I was born lived a man who sailed to sea, and he told us of his life in the land of submarines.
This is the entrance to the slide. They've all just entered. It's pretty smelly here, apparently. Why that is, it might be a bit blocked up with leaves or something, but yeah, we're going a bit further up. We're going to exit it for a now, so it should be interesting.
Name taken more times than I can remember, but nothing usually comes of it. The one time something did come of it, and I ended up in court, had a 12-month good behaviour bond, stuff like that. It was actually in the paper, which was really embarrassing. Had my name printed page two or page three of the Age, about page 15 of the Sun. Interferes with hospital workings or something. It was, we got in through a tunnel, happened to end up in the boiler room of a large Melbourne hospital, and security just kind of swarmed out. There was like 10 of us, it was an expo, and sort of a lot of people got away, but there were a couple that didn't, including myself. So we were just
called to turn up at the courts and charged with trespass and things like that.
Ever since I was a kid and I saw a movie called The Third Man with Orson Welles in, I always, like the tunnels in that were just like, you know, crazy. Like, they just made our tunnels seem so, you know, insignificant. And I always thought, yeah, it'd be good to do them one day, but never seriously thought about it. And when I did the first K-Fan video, I put all the highlights of the best drain footage and that in it. And just last year in 2001, we went over to Europe, and we sort of went to we went to Vienna especially to do these tunnels. And Vienna's a big city, and we basically picked a backpackers at random, and we just looked at this huge map, and we just went, oh, there's a canal that goes underground. Let's go there. There's quite a few canals. And we basically went straight to the point, climbed down and walked about 20 metres, and there was all these tourists outside this tunnel, and we thought, oh, I think we've got the right place. But we came back the next day, and it was it, and it was just exactly like the movie. Like, when we found every, like, normally it's the type of thing, like, you go there and it'd be really hard to find, and when you do find it, it doesn't look as good. You know, they always glamorise, but it was just really good, and it was just like, I remember just standing in there thinking, I can't believe it, I'm in the Third Man tunnels, you know. And I was like, there's one scene where the character, Orson Welles' character, Harry Lime, he sort of climbs under a low part of the tunnel, and we found that section, and I went under it, and I just took one step and slipped on my ass. And now when I see that scene, I just tell people, that's where I fell on my ass.
At the moment we're exiting through a manhole. I believe in the park. I'm not too sure, but it's going up there now. I'll probably go up next. It's a gutter box on a footpath. So
it's going to kick your ass over there.
It should be fun.
What it is to be a member of the K Clan?
The most obvious one is fun.
Fun, I guess.
Resolving curiosity, I suppose, or something like that. It's just like finding all this stuff that is under where you walk every day, where you go to work, where you know, these things that you're just regularly, every day you encounter from above ground, but you never see what's underneath it.
Beer and drains.
Yeah, it's interesting. You know, I get to see a lot of places that no one else sees and hang out with some nice people.
Weird, yes.
Go and drains, kids!
Humans with guns.
for me now, it's more kind of like my child. I like to see it grow, and I like to see new. I could go into a tunnel that I've been into 100 times and I'd be that bored, but I could take someone who I can tell is genuinely interested and I would get something from it. Because I'm getting emotional.